right. Welcome, welcome, our listening audience. We missed you. We missed you every Monday night, but we're back live, and we want to welcome you all over the globe to another great edition of We Love Rare Grooves. That's right, coming to you from the Groove Studios live here in Burbank on the Universal Broadcast Network. That's right, ubngo.com, channel 1. Tune in right now to ubngo.com, channel 1, because you're not going to want to miss this show. Hey, I'm your host, C. Mose, as we do every Monday night. We bring you the magic of the music and the music of the magic only here on We Love Rare Grooves. And we're going to share tonight. So, man, this artist that we have on tonight is just a wonderful, true young lady. And if you don't know, you will know tonight, as we do here on We Love Rare Grooves. We bring you the live music in-house only here on We Love Rare Grooves. So tune in. Give us a call, 323-524-2599. As we start off the show, as I say every Monday, I can't do the show without my great talented crew. And the crew tonight is starting off with the world famous DJ Reg. What you say, my good man?
Welcome, everybody. Happy Monday, everyone. Mondays. Been a long time. I get the little rust out the little thing, you know, rust out my voice and everything. Was sick last week. I think we got it back. Not as raspy as it was last week.
Man, we all been under the weather for the last month, man. But we've been grooving on Wednesday nights, though, at Harold and Bell's at the Peacock Lounge.
Peacock Lounge, off the chain. Off the chain. DJ. And we definitely appreciate everybody's support and everything coming on down. But we'll be back.
I want to thank Ryan over at Harold and Bell's.
And Matthew and the crew. So, thank you, guys.
As we do only here on We Love Rare Grooves.
And also thank my man, in his absence, the world famous AJ DeVoe.
I was going to say, there you go. He's doing his thing tonight.
Well, congratulations, and now a grandfather.
Oh, yeah, G-Pop.
Yeah, G-Pop, that's right.
That's what they call me.
Rare Grooves baby.
Yeah, that baby was blessed right on this show.
That's right.
You remember that, Tony, right?
Yeah, that was our little Rare Grooves baby.
I think they went home that night. Because they was hot after each other. Our DJ son came to a show. We had a guest, and their daughter was there. And lo and behold, they're married.
They got married, and they have a baby.
Met right here.
A little baby.
Was it here, or was it at the other studio?
At the other studio on Sunset Gower.
That's right.
And
this is history.
And your boy over there, that's right, the consultant.
Yeah, absolutely.
Come on, man, give me some energy. The consultant, man. You got to know your soul, baby.
How's everything going
with the book?
I'm working on another one.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So 1968, the year that black music changed.
Okay. I look forward to that.
Also, I want to say happy Valentine's Day to my Valentine, to my lovely wife.
Oh, we love this poem.
Wait. It's over.
I know, but listen, Bridget.
Now for him.
I'm trying to get some points everywhere I can.
He might need to clean up. He might have messed up and need to play clean up. Yeah, why you doing
this? Let him do his thing.
Clapping for me,
all right. Unwanted
plus. Man is still on a honeymoon.
As we continue here on We Love Rare Grooves on the honey. And then Jimmy G, what's happening, man?
Man, it's all about you. It's good to be back.
All right, man. Join us, hanging out.
Who's on that mic? Who's this? Please give him a big introduction. Give him a great introduction, okay?
Jimmy G, Satin Touch Production. That's right. Make sure get there.
He drives all of our legends.
Now you gotta do is talking. So now he's talking to the mic now. You know, he's talking on the side of the mic like this. Come on. Talking to the mic, sir. Right. Don't be shy.
Get him right, now. DJ Reg.
Hey, straighten me out, baby.
Yes, sir.
Straighten me out.
Let him know who you are. All right.
And then as we do, the glue that keeps us together, our talented, beautiful.
Right. Keep us on time.
Keep us on time. Our talented, beautiful co-host, Miss Shantani Iree. Hey. What you been doing?
Working.
Listen, well, we haven't seen you in a month or time.
I know. I haven't seen you guys. But we haven't been, you know, we haven't been here since Eddie and Brian were here.
You've been doing some performances or just working?
No, I've just been working in my tech job.
I thought you were going back over to Europe.
I need to. Never know, you know.
Big Red.
Hey, I'm waiting. I'm trying to go to Chicago with you so we can do this little co-production together.
Yeah, that's a done deal. A done deal. We're going to have that together.
Chicago?
Yeah, Donald Byrd Acoustic Experience.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we'll hop over there to Chicago.
Will you make your moves this past weekend, man? Will you
make your moves? As soon as we sign the contract, I will advertise.
Oh, as soon?
Right. Yeah. No, I mean, everything just has to be executed. So Kevin, Tony, and
you
I. You
going to hang them over the bridge and rock a bye, baby? I'm going to get them to sign a contract?
Hey, but we look forward to Chicago. We will be there. Right. We love Red Cruz. As we continue our show, we want to thank our sponsors as we do every Monday night. Beverly Boys Video
Production.
Beverly Boys Production, the go-to guys for all your video production needs. Give them a call, 1-800-385-1243. And also, we're going to welcome Drove Stogies. That's right, Drove Stogies. The clothing brand of Drove Stogies holds the same high regard for the finer things in life. Thread, smokes, good conversation, no frills atmosphere. Go up to Drove Stogies there on North La Brea Avenue. Tell them we sent you. You got to get up there.
I know. Y'all don't want me to go up there and meet nobody.
And also, our girl, Sweet Life, she sent out, reached over 100,000 people today at the advertisement. Yes. Sweet Life, welcome to the Sweet Life.
Sweet Life.
Experience the sweet side of managing events, and she manages all our events.
Absolutely.
So, without further ado, I know folks are waiting. Because we got a wonderful guest here in the Groove Studios. We got a songstress, a singer, an actress, a pianist, known as the queen of underground.
It's called Pianist, man.
Pianist. That's that Pittsburgh.
That
pianist.
That was close enough.
Okay, right. All right. We're going to let it go. Let it go.
You got to let me keep going, man. Don't interrupt me, man. I was going one.
That was,
Right. It was going so fast that people like, I know what he said.
Yeah, right. All right, go ahead.
She's a talented young lady who has proven throughout her career that the R&B artist can be progressive while remaining firmly rooted in her traditions. Foremost, she is a vocal range spanning 5 octaves.
Wow.
Five.
How many?
Five.
Five.
Not four.
Not four.
That's a lot of octaves.
Yeah.
Hey, and she started out, man, as background singer for
who?
The late Whitney Houston in the 90s. Oh,
nice.
Oh, were you with Alfie and them? When they did the South African tour?
No, I was after that.
She can't talk.
I had a connection.
We excited.
It's our first day back.
Okay.
It got a little rusty. We get it together.
And now she is working closely with the Grammy-winning trumpeter Chris Botti. Is that correct?
That's correct this
That's
time.
That's correct. All right. And also, she's worked with the Grammy-nominated group, and I really love this group, and I didn't know that, Foreign Exchange. And amongst
great host group,
of
great
other,
group.
Other artists that we're going to showcase tonight that she's lent her vocals to. But she's also, we want to share, is her Syberspace musical journey and her latest release. There's going to be a world premiere video tonight of the song Camelot from the highly acclaimed 2018 self-produced album Sometime a Rose Will Grow in the Concrete.
Sometime.
And this is our 5th release.
Wow.
So we're going to celebrate the music of the talented, beautiful, wonderful, man, did I say 5-octave voice of Miss Cy Smith. Welcome to the Groove Studio.
Hold on. One thing you did forget.
Uh-oh. Let's keep going.
You just forget one thing, man.
I know what he going to say.
She's fine.
I knew he was going to say.
She's fine. Okay, man, you just, important? She's fine.
Beautiful.
Hey.
And they can all see that.
But beautiful.
Thank you.
And she has all her teeth, too.
Oh,
look at
God.
Her. Beautiful.
Oh,
beautiful.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
Hey, without a doubt.
Yes.
Wow. So thank you. What an introduction. Thank you for that.
Oh, yes. That was just a little something.
I have to say one thing. I have never counted or measured my vocal range, so I don't know where that 5-octave number comes from.
Don't worry about it. Somebody wrote it.
Somebody wrote it.
But where's the piano? Oh. We can test it out. Where's the piano? Come on, let's find out.
I don't know what
so
my
you can
range
reduce,
really
so
is.
You can tell the truth and reduce it down to 4, 3, 2.
I just
one.
Never count.
You never
my
count.
My voice is always changing. And what I can do up top changes, and what I can do down in the bottom changes.
So tonight we might see what you can do. We've had a guest here before that says she's 5-octave and did a little something. So,
oh, Lord.
I got some tea for you.
Okay.
I got some tea for you. So welcome to the Groove Studios.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm excited.
And I must say, when we seen you at the Miracle Theater several weeks ago.
Yeah.
I was truly blown away.
Wow, really?
You remember how close I was? I was almost on stage.
You were
trying to film you, but
oh my god!
What a psycho!
Beautiful.
How did you get in? Did you break in?
You know that you were coming high on or something. Well, oh, you know,
it did seem
get
like
close.
I broke in. Then I just walked back in the dressing room.
You
like,
did come right back to the dressing room.
Like,
really? No. Would you knock on the door? Or did you kick the door down?
No, there was no just, door.
It was a curtain. I peeked in, and she's like,
"Really?
This tall Negro at the door.
Right?
He got somebody waiting. So I'm going to just say hi to them because they must be." Somebody.
Because I know they didn't just come back here.
I've never been afraid of a tall Negro or a big Negro.
Oh, hey!
Hey!
Tall or big.
We like that.
But it was fun to have you. It was fun to meet you guys that night. I'm glad you enjoyed the show, too.
Oh, I'm a fan. I've already.
Thank you.
The energy.
Really?
The energy.
Oh, man.
The spirit.
Thank you. It was my first L.A. show in a year, so I was really happy to just, you know, be back in L.A. performing, you know.
Now, for those people who don't know who Cy Smith is, how would you sum up Cy Smith as an artist today?
Oh, my gosh.
What is your music like? Who are you as an artist?
Oh, that's a really tough question, because I really am an amalgamation of everything that I have always been and everything I'm continuing
about.
To
Big
be.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord. But yeah, I'm a sum of so many things. But whatever you consider soul music to be, mm-hmm. all that encompasses jazz and hip hop and R&B and go go and funk. I'm all of those things.
Nice.
You know? Yeah,
wow.
For sure.
Can't put her in no box.
Sure.
Nope. No.
And so your new record, A Rose Sometimes Grows in Concrete.
Yeah.
What would that? How would you sum that record up?
Like that record leans jazz at first, mm-hmm. and then it takes a dip. You know, it totally goes somewhere else. With a song like Closer Than You Know, but I wrote and produced that whole album.
Wow.
You know, so it's the first time that I didn't collaborate, you know, on music or lyrics with anyone. Mm-hmm. And I just sat at the piano and wanted to have my Roberta Flack moment.
There you go.
You know?
Love it.
So that record is really, you know, probably the most transparent, you know, Cy Smith that I've released yet, mm-hmm. you know? Yeah. Me just really embracing my grown woman.
Yeah, I love it.
You know?
So we're going to go all the way back to the first one, too, that wasn't released, but now you can get on iTunes.
Wow,
right,
we
Cycle?
Got two colors.
I bootlegged it and
did
released
you?
It. Sure did.
Okay, so you know we have it, and you know we have it, too, right? So we're going to go right back to, we got callers already.
You
wanna
take callers.
Callers.
Right, let's take callers. Do your thing, Shantani.
Thank you for calling We Love Rare Grooves. Who do we have on the line? Hello, Koala.
Uh-oh, we can't hear.
Hello. I'm trying to see who had said it was.
Uh-oh.
Go.
Hello, caller. Thank you for calling We Love Rare Grooves. Who do we have on the line? No one. Hello. Up. Oh. Well, at least they know the number.
at least they know the number.
So that was two calls. And we'll have some more. Call 323-524-2599. So tell us, how did the musical journey start? Is it family? Did you come out of the womb singing? Is it...
I did not come out of the womb singing. I have always been a musician, and I think my first instrument was piano, and I took, my mom had me in these like really hood piano lessons, like it was like public, you know, public rec center piano lessons, and I think I was in a class with about, you know, 12 other kids, and I was about 6 years old, and you know, each of us got like 5 minutes. You know, with the teacher. And
with the one piano?
Yeah.
And was it in tune, the piano?
It was an electronic piano.
Okay.
But I remember saying to my mom, and I was 6 years old, and so I didn't really have the words to articulate it, but I was like, Mom, I just want it where it's me and the teacher, where it's just me and a teacher. And she was like, oh, you want private lessons? And I was like, yes! That's what I want. Private, that sounds like some exclusive thing, and that's what I want. And so she finally put me in private lessons when I was 8, and that began my sort of classical journey. But I still didn't start singing for another couple of years. I tried out for choir when I was in second grade or third grade. No, it was third grade. I went to Naylor Road Private School in Southeast D.C.
Wow.
And
hold up, Southeast?
Southeast, yes. Oh. And I tried out for the choir, and the teacher had she said to me, okay, sing the solfège scale. And I was like, what? Solfège. And I'm like, solfège? What is that? And she was like, you know, like the sound of music. Do, re, mi, fa, sol. And I had no idea what she was talking about. I came from a very, very, very black household. I had not seen the sound of music, and I didn't know what do, re, mi, fa, sol was. I didn't know what she was talking about. And I clammed up, and I did not make it into the choir. And
you should have sang the Wiz.
I should have. But I was so embarrassed because I didn't know what she was talking about. And it was such a cultural schism for me at the time. Yeah. And I vowed to myself, I was never going to mess up an audition again because I was so mad because everybody else made it into choir. Kimba and Tahemba and Shada and Jada and all of them made it. And I was like, they can't even sing, you
that
know.
Stayed on your mind.
It stayed on my mind. I'm still mad about it.
You notice she's still upset.
30 years later, she's still noted.
Yeah. I can hold grudges like.
Uh-oh. Hey, excuse me. Move over a little bit? Let me get on over, close over.
No, but you know, it was one of those things I was really mad at myself, and it took me 2 years and changing schools before I would audition for a choir again.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow. And so it wasn't until fifth grade at my new school in PG County where my music teacher said, you know, Sai, you should try out for Prince George's County
so
Honors
Choir. So
you moved
from Southeast to PG.
Yeah,
okay.
We moved, yeah.
Moving on up.
Moving on up a little bit, you know. Not much, a little bit.
Now, who were some of your early musical influences?
I always gravitated towards bands that had big horn sections.
Oh, so you like the big bands?
The big bands, like I was into like Kool and the Gang and Earth, Wind and Fire and
Cameo,
you know, the Barcaze and Cameo. Yeah.
Power of Power.
Yeah, any of those bands that had lots of horns because that's what my ear gravitated towards. Okay. I was always into, you know, like that was my thing, and I thought I was gonna be a horn arranger, you know, when I was a kid. Like that was what I thought I was gonna do, and I ended up not playing a horn at all. You know?
No woodwinds, no horn.
No, I tried clarinet. Uh-huh. I did. I tried B flat clarinet, but I could never get my embouchure right.
Oh.
So I gave up. But I always imitated horns, you know. Mm-hmm. So I think it's probably no coincidence that I sing with a trumpet player now.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
It was always something I heard, you know. But yeah, and then, you know, growing up in D.C., you can't help but be influenced by the go-go bands.
Absolutely.
You know?
Yeah.
Hit the Godfather for a minute.
Yes. Chuck Brown.
At the end. Yeah, give her a little bit of the Godfather. The one at the end. You got, but go ahead, continue on.
Now, besides your influences that we know, who were some of the influences that we don't know, like in your neighborhood?
Yeah, I mean, like, people probably don't know the go-go bands that I was influenced by. Like, Junkyard wasn't a household name. I mean, people know Sardines now, but back then, you know, Junkyard was like a DC thing. And I remember seeing them play, and they were kids like me. And I remember seeing them play at the Children's Museum, you know, and Rare Essence and, you know, EU and
Treble Funk.
Yeah, Treble Funk, exactly.
Now, where were some of the spots that you guys used to perform at? If you were an artist coming up, independent artist, where were the hot spots to go to?
Well, I mean, when I was a teenager, I didn't perform at any of those places because I wasn't allowed, you know. But there was like, you know, Breezes, Metro Club, and the Ibex. I actually performed at the Ibex.
You performed at the Ibex.
Yeah, because when I finished.
Right there on Georgia Avenue.
Yes, when I finished high school.
This one right here.
When I finished high school, my mom let me join a go-go band, which is what I always wanted.
They were called what, The Time or something?
No, Royalty.
Royalty
Queens.
Royalty Queens,
yes,
that's right.
We were about that queen life before anybody.
I love it.
And we were an all-girl go-go band.
The Ibex, that was always my spot because I would drive down Georgia Avenue and have to make that left.
Now, what was you doing down there?
Visiting, because D.C.
Freshman year. I was going to Howard and visit them.
No, I was going out, but I was dating someone in D.C.
I figured that's what it was. Yeah. I was trying to figure out why it was. I knew it was, you know.
Yeah, I was dating someone in D.C. Rock Creek Park and all.
I knew it was something that
I experienced Rock Creek Park.
She's going to get the truth out of you one way or the other.
I experienced Rock Creek Park. So. Yeah. But here's the Godfather, right? We thought we'd throw a little bit of the Godfather in there.
This music was so quintessential DC.
Oh, man.
And you hear it, and it instantly takes you back to that time. And what Chuck was doing was he schooled us on jazz without you know, beating it over our heads, you know? And there's a whole generation of, you know, Washingtonians, at least black Washingtonians, that just have jazz repertoire, you know, because of Chuck Brown, you know? Yeah. So it was a really sweet experience to grow up like that.
You know? I'm going to end it, but I remember going there and seeing them put out the yellow wooden things to shut off the street. And then block
party
and just put a go-go band, because I'm from Pittsburgh. I'm like, how they shutting down the street? And then now it's a band right in the middle of the street, and then it's go-go.
Yeah.
So,
like, every neighborhood had their own band almost, right. It seemed like. And if you had any inkling towards music, you know, you wanted to play in that band, you know?
So let's talk about the first album that you did. You got on a label.
Mm-hmm.
And was that in D.C. or did you move out
there? No, that was out here.
I
had moved out here and I was shopping around my songwriting catalog. I moved out here to be a songwriter.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so all of the songs I wrote, I demoed them because I could sing. But people thought my songwriting demo was a record, like a recording artist demo.
Oh, okay.
And so, you know, record companies were like, oh, you should just sign her, like, you know, or just get a deal. And I was like, no. That's not what I want. I'm just a songwriter, you know. Mm-hmm. And finally, I just was like, let me just take a record deal if that's what's going to get my songs placed, you know, even if I have to sing them. And I don't know why I was running from that for so long, but when I did sign the deal and I started doing shows, I was like, oh my God, this is what I want to do. I had never seen myself as like a lead singer.
Mm-hmm,
you know, right. I played keyboards, I sang background, I was good
for
all
of that.
He
was about the music.
Yeah,
he was about the music.
But I never really saw myself up front like that until I had to be. And then I was like, oh, hell yeah, this is what I want to do.
Well, let's get into the music for that first song on there from
Psycho Soul. Quote,
from Psycho Soul.
Oh,
we're going to go all the way back to Psycho Soul with Good and Strong.
Oh, my
like,
God.
That's what we're going to do. So give us a call at 323-524-2599. That's right. We got the queen, underground soul herself, Cy Smith, in the house tonight. I'm going way back.
Way back.
Wait, we're going to take you on a musical journey tonight.
A good strong man.
sit back, relax, and listen to the 8-track. I dig it like an old soul record.
Yes, I'm digging you. I dig it like an old soul record, baby.
Just sit back, relax, and listen to the 8-track. I dig it like an old soul record. Remember back in the day when everyone was black and conscious, down for the struggle. That brought us all together. Sit back and talk, cultivating a positive vibe. Blue lights in the basement. Freedom was at hand and you could just taste it. It was so cool.
Digging on me, digging on you. Everything was cool. Yeah, yeah.
My brothers were saying,
ain't no one another one.
Listen to the 8-track, I dig it like an old soul rap. Now brothers facing, run up on the beat down cops that be chasing. I'm running out of time, I'm running out of patience in this world of the conscious mind. I need some black on black, oh baby. Slow grind for the change of time. Thank you.
My name's Dave Patterson. I'm a Seattle area videographer. I've been working with Beverly Boy Productions for over 2 years, and I can say they are great to work with. They've always provided me with the information I need so that when I show up on set, I can shoot exactly what's necessary to tell the story the client is trying to tell. Call sheets that include the who, what, why, where, when of the video shoot, production notes, gear requirements, crew requirements, load-in time, all that. Makes my job a lot easier, and ultimately it produces the results that the client's going to be happy with. This is what a professional company like Beverly Boy Productions does, and also it's one of the reasons why I really enjoy working with them. It's a bit of a family vibe. They're very low-key, low-pressure, but they're very professional at the same time, and they get the results, and that's ultimately what matters most. I'm proud to be a shooter for Beverly Boy Productions, and if you're looking for a company to produce your next video production, by all means, give them a call. They can handle any sort of scale project from a single-person interview to a large production with multiple cameras and large crews. You won't be disappointed with the results. Give them a call.
Welcome back to the Groove Studios. Here you got C-Mos and the crew here, DJ Reg, Robert, Jimmy G, and also our co-host Shantani sharing the music, Syberspace, only from Cy Smith. That's right. We went back in the Groove Vault.
Yes, Cycles.
Oh, right? We went in the Groove Vault. Did you enjoy that?
I did. It was nice. It was like going back down memory lane.
So that's taking you back in the beginning when you came out to L.A.
Yeah.
Looking to be a songwriter. So,
right.
What year did you come out?
I came out here in like the end of 96.
So after you left Howard.
Mm-hmm. After I left Howard, I worked on Capitol Hill for a while.
Oh my goodness.
For the county of Santa Clara, California.
Wow.
For their lobbyists. Yeah.
Okay. So you were a bison. Is that what they
That's
call
right.
you?
That's right. We are bison.
Yeah. So for those Howard alumni listening, she's alumni.
I am
she's
a mighty
bison.
And so you came out here in 96.
Uh-huh.
And what was your...
I came out here. I had a good friend who went to Howard, also named Gordon Campbell, a drummer.
Oh, I know Gordon,
you know Gordon
very well. Yeah.
So Gordon had come out here because he was touring with Shy.
Mm-hmm.
Da da do do do.
Go ahead, go ahead, girl.
And I had a flashback.
And so Gordon was like, "Do you want to tour with this new artist I'm working with named Kenny Lattimore?" And I was like, "Yeah." And so that was my first gig. My first road gig. I think I started that in 97.
That's Kenny from D.C. area.
Yeah, and actually, Kenny went to my high school and he went to Howard.
What high school?
Eleanor Roosevelt.
Okay.
Greenbelt.
Oh,
you
look like a Baloo girl.
Manny knows all this.
That's
like,
it's hilarious. But yeah, so that was 97 that I started working with Kenny. But before that, Gordon had introduced me to a lot of different producers. Mm-hmm. So Sauce... and Sauce and Roe and Jeff from a group called Something for the People.
Uh-huh.
Something for the People had just finished working with Brandy. Mm-hmm. They produced some of that stuff on her first album. Mm-hmm. And they had their own group, and they also worked with a new artist coming out named Eric Benet. Mm-hmm. You know, and they all had shared an apartment over there on like Orange Grove or Peach Grove, one of those off of
Orange
Lancashire.
Grove.
Yeah.
Morrison
Lancashire. That's where everybody
lived.
I lived near Orange Grove.
Yeah.
Not Pasadena Orange Grove, is it?
No.
Okay. Lancashire.
Lancashire.
Oh, that Orange Grove, in North
Hollywood.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Peach Grove, Orange Grove, and Morrison.
That's
and
where
Huston,
they all lived.
And they all lived over
right.
there. So Sauce kind of took me under his wing and saw something in me and kind of was teaching me how to produce, you know, and how to craft my songs. And I used to go out there. He ended up buying a house in Chino Hills, and I would go out there and just write songs all the time with Sauce. And, I remember he was working with an artist named Puff Johnson. Wow. Rest in peace, Puff. There were just so many different artists. Terry Dexter was another artist they were working
with. Oh, our Terry Dexter.
Yes.
She's been on here
show.
Before.
Yeah.
She's from Detroit. She's on
yes,
over. Yeah.
Yes. Mm. So I just remember, like, my eyes were just big at all of these, you know, names of people that had record deals. And mm-hmm. There's a chance I might be working and writing with them. Mm-hmm. That's awesome, you know. And that's how I sort of developed my catalog, was with Sauce. And yeah.
So did you major in music at Howard?
No, I majored in psychology.
Okay.
Psychology with a minor in music therapy. So I was in the School of Liberal Arts, which became the College of Arts and Sciences, and my minor was in fine arts.
Because when I think of Howard, obviously, I think of the music tradition.
Absolutely. And I think I just...
had a great gospel department and everything.
All of that. And I actually did sing in the university chorale, just picking up on my choir experience that I did from elementary through high school. But I felt like I was coming from a high school where I was pre-engineering in high school, and I didn't think I could, you know, like compete, or not compete, but, you know, stand up next to those fine arts kids, you know, because all of those kids were coming from, you know, like Duke Ellington or, you know, the school in New York, you know,
Juilliard.
LaGuardia. And I was just like, I can't work, you know, like, but I didn't realize that I was just as, you know, talented, you know, as they were. You know, it's just one of those things. We're so quick to judge ourselves short, you know. So yeah. But yeah, I was a psychology major.
So then you were talented and smart, huh?
I did graduate magna cum laude. I won't stop you from saying that.
That little gold cord. You had a little gold cord.
I did have a gold cord.
All right.
I graduated magna. Thank you, laude.
What's some of the best advice that you would say you receive in this music industry?
I remember someone saying to me, and I don't know how much I agree with it, but I see what they were saying, to leave a little mystery with yourself.
Like, absolutely.
Not, that's absolutely
yeah,
true.
Absolutely.
To not
especially
be,
as a woman.
Yeah, well, yeah. Mm-hmm. But even just, you know, being out and about everywhere, mm-hmm. they were like, you don't have to be everywhere, you know? Leave some mystery. Mm-hmm. Let people look for you. You know.
Mystery.
Yeah. So that was a nice little piece of
advice. She was waiting for me to say something smart.
Something out of control. I knew. But that's true, because then you can. There's a fine line between somebody that'll go to the opening of an envelope and somebody who is, you know, irrelevant. There's a fine line to, you know, and sometimes you can be a little too much overexposed. And,
right.
True.
You know, so that's
and
true.
There's sometimes where you feel like, you know, I got to be at this place, I got to be at that place, and I got what they were saying, like, maybe I don't have to be everywhere.
Right, wear the dress a little longer so that has something to peek under.
Right.
That's not what they were talking about. They weren't talking about.
Did you see Shanti, how she looked at you?
That's what he was talking about.
She looked at him like.
I knew exactly what he was talking about. I was waiting for it. I was waiting for it. He couldn't help himself.
Before we get back into the music, tell us something that your audience would be amazed to know about you.
I read a lot of science fiction books.
Okay.
Like, especially sort of alien life forms and that kind
of thing. Oh, there you go, Tony.
Here it comes.
There we go, Tony.
Here it comes.
Oh, my God.
Tony visits, what is it, Studio 54 or whatever
no,
it's called?
No, Area 51.
Area 51.
Oh, my God. Tony was probably at Studio 54, too.
Right.
He probably was there, too, back in the day.
Yeah. Hey, give us a call here. Talk to Miss Cy Smith.
Yeah.
323-524-2444.
$25.99.
Sometimes I'm a little slow, like Uncle Joe. But yes, give us a call, and we're live right now on UBNGO.com Channel 1, and also Facebook Live. So holla at a sister.
Holla at a sister.
Please.
So now, what's our second? What are we going into next?
For show.
Wait, do you want to know how I came up with this?
That's what we want to know. How you came up with
this? Okay, I was doing a lot of shows at the time here in LA, and I wanted a song to open my show with. You know, I was like, I don't want to just come out with anything. And I was listening to a lot of Coltrane at that time.
Right, and that's.
And so this is based on a Coltrane song
from
1960. Yeah, Saida's Sweet Flute.
Right.
So you know, yeah, and I love that. You know, so I was like, it'd be really cool to take that groove and just like use it as a show opener. Boom. And that's how it came out. And so I just took the same chords. Thank you, Mr. Coltrane, and brought it to the band. Cassandra was playing with me at the time. I think Cassandra. Who else was in the band at the time? Agape on guitar.
I think I heard the name.
Yeah, but and the lyrics are very much a show opener. Hey y'all, What up, though?
Right.
I'm glad to see you. What up, though? That's Detroit. Glad to see you at the show.
Mix
you all
up.
Look beautiful. Too bad I'm not single. I was totally single when I wrote that. I want
to see you. That's that mystery. We were talking about that little mystery.
No shame in her game.
That mystery.
She's fine and she's single.
But yeah, that's the story behind for show.
I wanted to share. I'm glad we were on the same page.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Here we go.
That's crazy. For the something for the radio. Yeah. Hey, y'all. What up, though? Glad to see you. At my show, hey, you all look beautiful. Yeah, too bad I'm not single.
Damn,
I wanna get you in the mood. Don't be scared to move. Let it all out tonight and leave here same size tight for sure.
Yes, indeed,
for sure. Bartender hooks you up, show some love in the cup, last but not least, give us some energy,
energy,
positive, it's the best. If you're unsure, just show your breath for sure.
Mine, cause to me you're one of a kind. Saying doing things with no damn decency. I'm not saying that I wanna stop.
Smith, that was Perspective. I like that
Thank
record
you.
Right there.
Clean.
Girl. I like that.
Thank record. You so much, y'all.
It's real clean, girl. I have
oh, yeah.
In my playlist right now.
That is beautiful.
Thank
that
you. Beautiful.
You got him talking to himself.
Right. You know, I got to talk to the audience. Welcome back to We Love Red Blues. We have Cy Smith in the house. Hopefully you're enjoying this music. It's great music from
great
Cy
music.
Smith. And we blended her in with Chaka Khan. Cameo. You never thought your music would play like that.
We have a caller that's actually on air.
Okay.
Thank you for calling We Love Red Grooves. Who do we have on the line? Hello, caller. I just heard you.
I heard you too.
What happened to you?
Still are you there? In the back somewhere?
Big Pimpin', are you there?
He was like, hello?
I heard him.
They hung up.
Oh. They got scared. Five calls.
Don't be
today.
Scared.
You guys don't have to be scared of Miss Cy.
Yeah, just because she's so talented and so fine, don't be scared.
Sometimes
step up to the plate.
Away, you know?
All right, take me away to Drove Stogies, and beautiful. We'll come back. Maybe they'll come back.
All right.
On this second year anniversary of Drove Stogies, we have the red carpeting, so when you pull up, you see the red carpeting, and then as you continue through into the cigar lounge, by the way, we have a beautiful humidor, which is where I'm at, and then as you go into the lounge, the ambiance is beautiful, the artwork, you sit down, you relax, we have TVs, we have music, and then where it's really happening is outdoors in the back where we do have live entertainment, we have a bar, and we have great food by Nay's Tacos, so hopefully you come out and enjoy.
Because of the fact that we're a membership-based organization, our members create the fabric of what the culture is here. And we really feel that we have a camaraderie here that revolves around the fellowship, around the leaf, the cigar.
Oh, the caller keeps hanging up. Cy is scaring these people away.
Don't be scared. Don't hang up. We
don't
need
be scared.
Oh, oh, my goodness.
Hang up. Oh, no.
803.
803, where is that?
I have not the slightest
idea. I have
idea.
No idea.
Call back, 803. Call don't back. Be scared.
I told you it sounded like it was a, well, God bless your heart. Call us back.
Jimmy wants to hear from you.
Drove Stogies for the good life.
As we get ready to take you on our little contest here with Shantani.
Oh, it's Central South Carolina. That's who was on the phone.
Central South Carolina.
So I wasn't halfway off.
So I got one question before. Are you guys getting ready for Shantani in 60?
Yes, I'm already ready.
You already ready?
I was born ready.
You were born ready?
Okay. Well, I got to get ready.
Well, I just want to ask one question before that. Can I ask it? So tell us what you find quite a little different from when you started out 96 with music compared to when you started, you know, because back then you had the record and just something comparably different.
What I didn't really have anything until 99.
Okay.
You know, 96, I was still bright-eyed and bushy-tailed and, you know, eating at, you know, the Sizzler was a good restaurant.
In your 20 years.
The Sizzler still pops now. All you can eat buffet. Come on now.
I ain't that.
No, but just in that 20-year span, what have you seen different in the music industry, of course?
Well, the technology, of course, has made it so that, you know, anybody can record. And that's a good thing because I think we get to hear from a lot of voices that previous to the technology being so easy, you know, were sort of marginalized, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Now you don't have to, you know, have $1,000 a day to go into a studio, really. But I think also some of the craft has been sacrificed, you know, for that reason, because everybody is not as specialized as we used to be. You know, there was a person who did mastering and a person who did, you know, mixing. And, you know, there were big 2-inch tapes that sounded like candles and wax. And, you know what I mean? So the technology has made it so that we are not so specialized. And I think sometimes the craft can get lost when we don't pay as much attention to those details, you know.
I do.
Yeah. I mean, I know there are some of us who still do, but you know. When the content creators aren't paying as much attention, you know, they're just putting out product, you know, just a song, an album every 3 months. You know what I mean? And when that happens, I really do think that some of the quality can get lost. You know, it's like McDonald's as opposed to, you know,
mass producing
Morton's.
Anybody can create music when technically not anybody can create music. There was a time where musicians were a certain group of people.
Right.
And now anybody makes music.
And like and some of that was a good thing and some of that was a bad thing. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, it was a bad thing that a lot of times you had to have a deal to even get into a studio. And it was a bad thing that only, you know, the white guys owned the studios and black people didn't, you know. And it was a bad thing that you know, women couldn't get into any of them places without having, you know, some kind of Svengali guy, you know. So I see kind of two sides of it, you know. But I think in the end, it's always better when there are more people playing the game, you know. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Makes sense.
Do you see yourself as a songwriter or a singer first? Ooh. Somebody made you pick one, what would it be?
I was a songwriter first. Mm-hmm. I was a songwriter before I even let people know I could sing. I was always sitting around writing little songs. You know, songs to my mama, you know, songs to my dad, songs to whomever would listen, my stuffed animals. Anybody got a song. You got Jimmy G, you get a song. I was like, Oprah, you get a car. You get a car. You know, I was always writing songs and poetry, and I always had a love for words and language. And I was a reader, an avid reader from a very young age.
And leaders are readers.
Yeah, is that right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So we're going to do what we call Shantani in 60 seconds. I'm going to ask you a series of random questions, and you have to answer them in 60 seconds or less.
All the questions in 60 seconds?
All of them.
Okay, all right.
He's going to give me some walking music.
Is there a right or wrong?
No.
Okay.
What was your first job?
I worked at Jerry Subs and Pizza.
Your favorite song to perform?
Perspective.
She only has 60
Good morning,
seconds.
Heartache.
Name a lover gave you?
Bella.
Ooh. Greatest piece of advice?
Never stop learning.
I was born in 1984. What were you doing then?
I was in fifth grade.
If you could record or produce an album for a celebrity that is deceased, who would it be?
For a celebrity, it's just Prince.
If you hadn't made a career in music, what would you have done instead?
Made a career in acting.
If you could live again as an animal, which one would it be?
A giraffe.
Which superpower would you like to have? Invisibility, flying, or reading minds?
Invisibility.
Dream artist to work with right now?
Bruno Mars.
See, that wasn't too bad. That was 60 seconds.
Hey. She went through it, too.
Honey, she sure did.
Because some people...
I want to know what's Bella all about. I'm still stuck on that. But
leave it alone now. Leave it alone.
That's her mystery. That's the mystery. Yeah. That's that mystery.
Bella, she do as they tell her.
So we're going to go to our next segment of some people that you work with or sampled with.
Okay.
And we're going to have some fun with this, and then we'll come back and talk about those collaborations, a few others, and then... we're going to have the special mix.
Okay.
Video mix.
The special
video mix.
Next for Miss Si.
All right.
So, DJ Reg, what you got on this first one, man?
Let's check me out on this one. All right?
Check you out on this one. Check out these mixes that you lent your voice to.
I love it. Oh,
Don't make moves and complain round here. In the street, it's the same hot here. MI to TX, we drove down here. I was 7 that year, Charlestown, Southwest, laid my head down there. Niggas wild out there, on the way to class, brother shot laid out where? Car park, dry blood in his hair, had a million miles stare, no police anywhere, just prostitutes and fiends and kids all aware that this ain't the place to be, so yo, Northside is a place to be, so yo, U-Haul, man, we had the ghost, so yo, Audubon Park is where I call my home, it's no Fifth Ward, but what I know, so yo.
All right, man, let's get this show on the road, man. I done said enough, I got to go to the bar and get me another beer and shit, for real. Coming up to the stage first. To set this whole shit off.
Let the show begin.
All systems go. Thank y'all so much. Thank y'all for listening. Spine Tigger. And I do this all for hip hop. I'm lying like shit. I do this shit for my goddamn mortgage, nigga. For my bills. Fuck am I fooling? New tickle.
Hey yo, stand clear. You are not a man if you cannot stand here.
Hey, what you say? 25 from around the way. Many times passing by. If you smile just a little bit, baby. Kinda new to the ways of love, but I'd like you to show me what you do when you do your thing. Kinda forward, I know you say, but you've been asking around about me. Always do, got to do a little bit of research, baby. I don't wanna waste no time, I want you to show me what you do.
Maybe the lateness of the hour makes me seem bluer than I am. But in my heart there shower. I hope she'll be happier with him. Baby, the darkness of the hour makes me seem lonelier than I am.
Sy Smith.
We
love Smith.
I love you guys.
Reggie.
I love you guys.
Reggie.
What's that?
Sy Smith.
Sy Smith.
Y'all are funny. What are y'all doing? What? Is Stevie Wonder about to come in here and sing?
Yes, he
is. Oh my God. Oh.
So pre happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Pre happy birthday.
Birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Hey.
Right. Ready? Blow them out.
All right. Oh, this is really sweet, you guys. Thank you so much. I'm moved to tears.
We ain't finished yet.
Right here.
Oh,
we
got
finished. Yeah, we just getting started.
My gosh. Okay.
You need some.
We about to. She's getting a little emotional.
Don't worry about it, dear. We're going to play some more of your music.
Okay,
you'll be okay.
I'm going to blow these candles out, though.
Okay, go ahead.
Do your thing.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Si Smith. Oh, isn't that sweet?
We got smoked out.
It is.
Thank
smoking.
You all. This is so sweet.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Happy birthday
you
from the We Love.
You were conspiring to do this.
Yes, because you kept getting your ear hustle on.
I'm sorry.
Literally, I'm in the back trying not to burn
it. I didn't know it. I thought you were going to smoke some weed or something. I didn't know what was going on.
Oh.
I mean, you know,
I was going to clean some seeds
earlier
off of your new album. That's why I wanted you to get the album, so clean some
really
seeds.
Really sweet.
Is that Tony,
aka
B Slade?
Yes.
You know he's been on here too. We love
B Slade. I love B Slade. Yeah. That is my
He's looking for B Slade.
Not
he
only
said
did
he's
he
come back.
Do not only did he produce some remixes for me, but he's on one of the remixes.
Nice.
He sparked that whole remix project. Yeah. Oh my gosh, this is so sweet, you guys. Will you send me that picture, please?
Oh, we're gonna send you the picture.
Okay.
We got
you.
Send him this picture.
Yeah.
So now we're going to get back to some more interviewing.
I can't think.
Yes, you can. How did you come up to collaborate with Chris? How did Chris Botti find you?
Chris Botti found me because my cousin Mark Whitfield is a guitar player and used to be in Chris Botti's band.
Okay.
So Mark told Chris, you know, like, you should call my cousin up. He had a singer already, but I think he was looking for something different. And Mark said, you should call my cousin up. And Chris was like, really? Okay. And never heard me.
Right.
You know, there was really not YouTube popping like that back then. And, you know, they called me up and was like, do you want to do a gig with Chris? And I was like, sure. And they sent me the song. There was no rehearsals or nothing. They just sent me a plane ticket and I, met them in Atlantic City and showed
clothes.
Up for sound check. Yeah. Showed up for sound check and met Chris and we ran like half of, we ran like one verse of each song, So he's like, okay, let's do the Look of Love. The look of love is in your eyes. Great. Okay, let's do Good Morning Heartache. Good Morning Heartache.
Uh-huh. Which one did you do? Did you do Natalie Cole's version?
No, Chris Botti's version.
Oh, okay.
Good Morning Heartache. And then he was like, okay, great. And then he was like, let's do What'll I Do? And then just.
That's great, because those are all standards.
Yeah,
those
and all, which I was prepared for. But what I wasn't prepared for is that. What are you talking about? What I wasn't prepared for is that these cats don't rehearse.
Oh.
So that blew my mind.
They don't rehearse?
No. And I'm coming from R&B and pop world where we rehearse 40 hours a week for 3 weeks before we leave to go on the road at all.
It's like, what you see is what we get. Here we go. Hit it.
Jazz guys don't rehearse?
Not if they're doing standards.
I've been in the wrong. Well, I mean, and Chris's gig, it's some standards, but it's still Chris's way.
Right.
What I came to understand about his gig is that he likes for things to naturally evolve, So that's why he doesn't really rehearse. He just kind of chooses the cats for what they do, and then he lets them do what they do.
That's what I hired you for.
Yeah. until it becomes a thing, And if we hit on something that feels good, he might mention it to you the next night. Like, remember when we did this? Let's try that again. But otherwise, yeah, I can count on one hand how many times we've had an actual rehearsal in 10 years.
Now, in a non-digital world, remind the people in the 90s, how did you used to hustle music?
You mean like...
Like, how did you hustle your records?
I mean, I printed out my first EP in 2001. I think I printed out 1,000 copies. I didn't know what I was doing, And yeah, I sold them joints out the back of my truck at TGI Fridays.
There you go.
The Magic Johnson Fridays down there.
Yeah, on La Tierra. Right.
Yeah. Right.
That used to be the spot.
I used to show up to happy hour and,
I used to be up in there looking for some black Negroes.
That's in my area.
I used to be looking, honey.
Oh, you were just a young type.
No, I definitely was not.
Good Morning Heartache.
That was 10 years
Jimmy
ago.
Jimmy G likes Good Morning Heartache.
Both of us do.
You want me to sing it again?
Yeah, I love Good Morning Heartache. Yes.
Hit it.
Good morning, heartache. There's music playing. You old gloomy sight. Good morning, heartache. Thought we said goodbye last night. I'm emotional. I tossed and turned until it seemed you had gone. But here you are with the dawn. Wish I'd forget you, but you're here to stay, yes. It seems I met you when my love went away. Now every day I start by saying to you, good morning, heartache, what's new?
Oh yeah, man, thank you so that's much for that talking, bro. That just makes you what would DeVoe say that makes you like
feel chewy on the inside.
It's all chewy.
Put some socks on and blanket and just roll up.
My throat feels so ashy right now, you guys.
So, if that's ashy then boy,
we got the lotion.
Yeah, we do.
Y'all are a bunch of pigs.
I just want you to know that. I really want you to know that.
Thank you for that.
No, you're more than welcome.
So we got to go into
look, we wrote your name.
If not the lotion, we got the shea butter.
So we got to go ahead.
Butter, baby.
So we got to go to the Dusty of the Week. Right. Are we going to the Dusty of the Week?
He got the.
Hold on with this coronavirus cough. What's going on?
Oh, no. So the Dusty of the Week is brought to you by Sweet Events. And we go down into the crates. And
we go down into our mother's crates in the basement.
All right.
And we blow off the dust off of our records, and that's what we do when we cough.
And that's where the dust comes from.
Okay.
See? She's talking about,
no,
man.
I'm going away tomorrow. And I'm
She's like, you going over there, too.
You are going over there, too.
Before we go to the Dusty, though, Cy Smith, sometimes a rose will grow in concrete. Where can we pick this up at?
You can pick it up. Sometimes a rose will grow in concrete. I have physical copies. I have vinyl all at my online store at cysmith.com or cyberspace.bigcartel.com.
Can we Apple Music it on our playlist?
Can Apple Music. Lovely. You can Spotify. You can Pandora. You can Google Music. You can Amazon Play. All of that good stuff.
Lovely.
Anywhere
size
there is
everywhere.
Music. Yes.
Size
all your digital downloads. I love this cover picture.
My husband took that.
This is fantastic.
Thank you.
He's a great.
You heard that, guy? She's married. That's why they hung up.
She first she said she was single. Now she's married.
No, she said she wasn't single. She was.
Oh, wasn't single. I didn't catch that.
She was single at that time.
Oh, I didn't catch that.
That's why all those men hung up when they realized.
Exactly. Oh, yeah.
So
she said, "I'm not."
Oh, wasn't. We just wanted to share this because you did a little bit of her work.
Yeah.
From the Decoders.
Oh, yes.
So we're just going to mix another one in, and then we're going to give you another special treat for your birthday.
Okay.
So the Dust of the Week is brought to you by Event Suites, Sweet Life.
Okay.
Experience the sweet side of managing your events. Sarah Harris, every week she sends it out for us.
Check it out, boss. Go.
So what do you think about that?
That was so cool. What an honor to be, you know, played right behind one of my idols.
On here on We Love Red Grooves, we take care of you.
That's the way to do it.
Is that the way to do it?
That is, yeah.
Okay.
Woo! This is such a fun song to record, too.
Yeah, it's a great song. And you ain't, I couldn't tell the difference.
Whatever.
That was me. Because I'm a Cy Smith, I'm a Cyberspace guy.
Yeah.
So I couldn't tell the difference.
Look how you get that note.
Cy Smith.
Cy, you hit that note.
That's one of them octaves she said she had.
Right, man.
One of them octaves.
I can't do it right now.
That's
okay.
And I'm a man, and I can't get moist.
Hey.
Well, that's up for debate.
What was he the man?
That's up for debate.
Oh. All right. So, Pretty Tony, DJ Reg,
ready for that?
Robert A.
Shout out to the Dakotas.
Shout out to the Dakotas.
Dakotas.
So. Is this the surprise for her birthday?
Yes.
This is for her birthday?
Yeah.
Okay, this
her
is for
birthday.
Sasha. Her birthday.
Oh, okay, let's see.
Her birthday.
Her birthday. Her birthday. Okay. Got a nice little...
Staying down to earth is overrated. Weighing down my balloon, my stating. Baby, I want you and I can't wait until you tell me.
Good for the soul.
got a long way to go, but it won't stop the pain. That's the kind of thing that keeps me coming back again and again. Till I see your face, I won't be satisfied. No. And I won't stop. I won't quit until I'm yours and you are mine. And I can't live my life for nobody else but me. Trying to tell me what to do is really, really foul to me. Whoa, and that's the way that love goes. That's the way it goes. It's really good for the soul. Everybody should know that's how love goes. It's good for the soul, so good. And everybody should know that's how love goes. It's good for the soul. This is drunk, this is funky like a skunk. This is A, this is B, this is blind, can't you see? This is your brain on drugs. 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 Any questions? Any questions?
Conflict, opposites, psychological politics. Trying to live without regrets. Trying to make us all.
This is rock, this is roll. This ain't Neo, this is soul. This is capture, this is free. This is a gift to you from me. This is open, this is shut. This is asking what the this is crazy, this is sane. Can they be one in the same? This is legal, it's a crime. This is gonna do hard time. This is funny, this is sad. This is making me feel bad. This is really on the one. This is retro, this is now. This is gonna show you how. This is danger, this is safe. This is caution out of place.
It's kind of crazy.
Wait just to love you.
Now that I have found you, don't ever, ever go.
Give it all love to DJ Reg.
Oh, man. Thank you, DJ Reg. It's like a Cy Smith in retrospective.
There you go. Thank you very much.
So,
this is what I do.
I love it. Thank you.
We're going to do the world premiere, right?
All right.
Go ahead. Talk to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, and all life forms in between, this is the
life forms
Tony
in between.
Tony loved that. Tony like, hey.
Yeah, that was for him. This is the world premiere of my new single, Camelot, the video filmed in East Africa, a nation called Tanzania. And fall in love with East Africa with me. This is Camelot.
Come on.
La da da, yeah. Oh, la da da, yeah. Slowly, slowly over time. Skipping heartbeats feels just fine. Happens when you're
Birthday to Miss Syberspace.
I'm so happy that she came and did our show the eve of her birthday.
Thank you.
Because you know, most people, they'd be like, it's my birthday. I can't be bothered.
And she's going out of town traveling.
And she's leaving tomorrow.
This is true.
Yeah.
But you guys.
And we speak blessings for your trip.
Thank you. I really couldn't have spent my evening in a better place. This was awesome. Thank you so much.
We're like, oh.
So you've done a lot of interviews all over the world in different formats and studios.
None quite like this.
Nope.
This was the absolute best.
It was.
Let them know that.
It was absolutely wonderful. You guys are just, it's wonderful talking with people that get it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And between the five of you, you know, you've got all the bases covered, you know? So I really appreciate that. You never know, like, how you have no idea how many people. Like, it's the same questions.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Yeah.
But
did you sing in church?
Oh, yeah, we didn't even ask her that one.
Yeah,
right.
Thank you.
Right.
That's why I bring it up, because it's like, thank you for asking, like, really cool questions and digging in the crates. And,
right.
You know.
Doing our homework.
Yeah, I really appreciate that. Y'all pulled up brand new heavy stuff. I mean, all kinds of
stuff. I know, how did you get brand new heavy? You just did how many collab?
I just did one album with them back in 2002, and it was because Mike Ross, who was over their project at Delicious Vinyl, had been sort of,
Mike.
You know Mike Ross?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So Mike put me in touch with them, and, you know.
That's guy.
Who were you after?
It wasn't like I replaced anyone.
Okay.
I just did an album with them.
Okay.
Like, I didn't tour with them or anything.
Okay.
You know, they just, I think really I was just writing songs and singing.
Okay.
You know, because India and I are friends.
Okay.
You know, India. And she had actually called me up, you know.
India, right?
Yeah.
Because I just butchered it.
India, what'd you say?
That's why we just didn't just leave it there. That's the name.
You said Davenport, I think.
Right. I said her last name because I was going to butcher it.
Yeah. No, shout out to India. She's a queen. She's a queen.
So you all can get, sometimes a rose will go and grow in concrete, Sy Smith, on all of your digital downloads.
You show that.
Also, yes, this is gorgeous. This is the one I actually like.
Thank
this particular
you.
Picture is absolutely
you.
Gorgeous. Shout out to your husband for that.
Shout out. to Sean Carter Peterson.
Who?
And then, of course,
Sean Carter Peterson.
There you go.
And then, of course, and our alumni, B. Slade, is making an appearance on this record.
Big shout out.
He should have called into the show.
He sure should. I just texted him the picture. So we'll see. But yeah, I mean, you guys support good music. You guys, we always hear people complain about where is the good music? Where are the musicians?
Right,
well, they're out there. You guys have to support them.
Say it, Sean.
So download their music. Stream their music. Streaming is a big part of how they make their income now, too.
Yeah, yeah. Put them on their show.
Put them on
show.
Your playlist. Put them their on show. Your show. Yeah. You know, so no more complaining because they are definitely
out there.
She doesn't
mind opening
it
up for anybody.
That part right there, no more complaining. Because I'm always hearing people saying, nobody makes this anymore. Nobody makes that.
Yeah,
and we actually do.
But we do make it.
You know, it just doesn't. It is really easy to find. You know, if you find an artist, if you like me, for instance, start a Cy Smith station on Pandora or whatever, and you'll find other people like me. Mm-hmm.
There you
know,
really?
If you're really into PJ Morton, you know, station, all of that.
You don't have to get out of your house and go to Tower Records and wait in line anymore. Wow. You know,
right?
Save up your allowance. So you can just go online.
So
and
we
download.
Can start a We Love Rare Grooves.
Yes.
Oh yeah. We Love Rare Grooves is on Apple Podcasts.
That's
we're on
right.
all of those.
That's right.
We're but on y'all Spotify. Should have y'all should have a playlist though, like a playlist that you know every couple of months like update.
You know, we actually might have. We don't even know.
We had one on SoundCloud. One.
Well, we're on all the digital. People at work listen to.
Yeah,
right.
We do. Totally
we just
got to
update
playlist.
It a little bit.
We just got to update that one.
Yeah.
So.
What's your website again? Cyberspace?
Cysmith.com.
He's going to show it online.
And and my store is cyberspace.bigcartel. Yeah.
See that right there?
Yes, yeah, I love it. That's it.
That's it.
Click on me.
Is that it?
Welcome
that's
to it. Cyberspace. That's
it. It's blue. You can click on it, can't you?
It's a hyperlink.
Right. Okay.
So we're going to close out two things.
Okay.
Shantanee.
Top five. Who are your top five entertainers of all time, living or deceased?
Michael Jackson.
Okay. I love it. That's it. We take it.
No, I'm for real. Michael Jackson, Prince, Diana Ross, Ella Fitzgerald, and I'm going to have to say...
Sonny from La Louisiana.
Oh, my God.
No, I'm going to have to say Chaka Khan,
Sonny!
Actually.
Like
that's
Khan.
Why we played her tonight. Chaka Khan. Chaka Khan. Okay.
I feel for you.
Now you know we went over.
Oh, we should sing something together.
Hey, special thanks out for Marquita.
Yes, Marquetta Rodriguez. Marquetta. Shout
Marquetta. Out. He was gonna mess that
that's
name
okay.
up.
Okay, everybody does that.
Right, she
everybody
even told
does.
Me.
Yeah,
she's straight.
Marquetta.
But Marquetta is my right hand woman, and she runs a record store. One of the few remaining freestanding black-owned record stores
in
called
Houston.
Sirius Sounds in
wait,
Houston.
Where is it at? In Houston,
Houston.
Texas?
Yeah, Sirius Sounds.
What area of Houston is it in?
I just know it's on MLK.
It's in the
okay,
ward.
Okay, so it must be in the ward. Yeah, I was about to think that. Or Greens Point.
Okay.
Tell her I said thank you.
Well, we'll do, Jimmy.
Tell her
G.
I said thank you.
Yes, indeed.
But we really appreciate it.
So we have one more special thing for you.
All right.
From the team of here at We Love Rare Grooves, from Pretty Tony, DJ Reg, Robert, Jimmy G, Shantanee, and myself.
Uh-huh.
We want to give you the We Love Rare Grooves Award.
So
you
can
microphone, and it's live. It's a live mic.
Oh my gosh, it's a live mic.
It's a live mic.
So I know you'll be getting a Grammy soon, but
you can't use that as paperweight. You have to put it next to your Grammy.
Oh my gosh, thank you
picture.
So much.
Get the picture, hold the flowers, do the
I
picture.
Don't have a speech prepared, but please.
Yes, you do.
Okay. Yeah, you do. You just did.
You could talk about how you love the show one more time, and we're going to cut it short there.
I love We Love Rare Grooves, and I'm really honored to be here amongst you all. Thank you for having me. Thank you for this. I'm going to keep this really close to my heart.
Yes, please do.
Because you're close to our heart
thank
now.
Thank you.
Now you are. That's
true. So sweet. Oh, God. Y'all are trying to ruin me.
So many, just so you know, so many great legendary people have sat where you're sitting. So that really shows you what we think of your craft and your music and how we feel you fit into this show. Because very few people today fit into our show, mainly people of yesterday. So we've had a lot of giants and a lot of legends sit there. So.
Well, I am proud to stand on their shoulders. And, you know, they walk so people like me could run. And there I appreciate it. Thank you all.
And keep us abreast of what you're doing. You're part of our alumni, part of our family.
Thank you.
So when you are, particularly when you're appearing around here.
Yeah.
Somebody asked, when are you going to be performing next year? Somebody online asked.
Probably in August 1st at the Leimert Park Jazz Festival.
Oh, okay. We might have to pop
and
up
and you guys
over
are
there.
The first to hear that. I'm telling you first.
No, but I'm just saying, nobody introduced you that night at the Miracle.
That's true.
And I was supposed to introduce you.
Were you? Why didn't you?
Because nobody...
Oh my God.
They didn't know.
I didn't know.
Right. Because you just came out. Should have been me.
energizing the crowd, saying this is Cyberspace.
What a psycho.
You know what I mean?
Next time, man.
So I'm your hype man.
All right. All right.
He'll take hype man or bodyguard, whichever one. He'll take either one.
Thank you so much. It's been an honor and a privilege to be able to play your music.
Thank you so much.
DJ Reg doing the video mix and just the team putting this together here. As we said, it was going to be very special. I know you didn't know what to expect.
I didn't, but this was this is all overwhelming in a beautiful way.
So we went more than overtime. You know we got a few other things to do, so let's get it.
Okay.
So Pretty Tony, I know I went overtime again. Thank you so
Tony's
much.
Probably
thank
like, this you, is Tony. Why the aliens don't visit us. Tony's like, this is why they don't visit us, the aliens.
But we want to thank our listening audience all over the globe for continuing to support our movement here. We Luvv Rare Grooves, our project.
We are in 5 years now. Do you know that?
Yeah, we got to have a
this
big
is our slam. Fifth year on air.
We're going to do it down in L.A. Wisdom.
Over 5 years now, and we've had so many... You know, we've been very blessed.
And we want, and we want to thank our sponsors, Beverly Boys Production, the go-to guys for all your video production needs. Drove Stogies, that's right, Drove Stogies hold the finer things in life for the smokes, conversation.
And the men,
they got jewelry, they got socks. Special clothing.
I can't
membership.
Believe they sell clothes in a cigar shop. I'd love to see how that works.
No, it's not a store in there. It's custom made.
Oh, it's
made.
A tailor made
right,
to
custom
fit.
Made. That's
custom
right.
made?
Yes, custom yeah. made.
Look, Reggie, like, let me go down there.
And also, Sweet Events, The Sweet Life. Experience the sweet side of managing your events. Call Sarah today. Sarah Harris,
she hooks
girl.
Us up every week.
Yes, right. she does. So, next week, should I put it out there?
No.
Well, we put an invitation out there to Marcus Miller, so we'll see what happens.
We'll just put it out there.
If not, we're going to replay Cy Smith.
Where Marcus live at? Let me go knock on his door.
How about that? So, again, we want to thank our listening audience all over the globe. Continue to watch us on all we were talking
yes,
about.
Yes, continue to watch us on all of our digital connections. Instagram, We Groove Entertainment. Facebook, We Luvv Rare Grooves. You can follow us on Apple Podcast. You can follow us on iHeartRadio. We have our own channel on iHeartRadio, Spotify, YouTube. Our YouTube channel, this whole show will be replayed in its entirety, and you can watch it over and over again, along with all of our past shows from over the 5 years that we've been doing this.
So we look forward to great things here in 2020. Yes we will have to celebrate our 5 years, and also we got some great guests that we're reaching out to. And Cy, you are welcome back anytime.
Thank you so much, y'all.
Because since you know where we both are at, and you're like, hey, it's a Monday night, I ain't doing nothing.
All right,
let's hang out.
Y'all might get tired of me.
Hey,
no, Jim Gilshrap used to do that. Jim Gilshrap, when we were over on Pico, he took us for real. He came and stopped by every Monday.
But what a wealth of knowledge.
Oh, yeah. After he was a guest, then he would just come in and sit in.
We talked to Jim in a while.
I know, we do have to call him. I love him so much.
But he makes a sweet, very good
sweet potato pie.
Oh, that man can make a sweet potato pie.
When I paid
for I'm there every year.
Sweet potato pie.
Wow.
Twice a year.
Did you get one this year?
Absolutely. Come on, twice a year.
That sweet potato pie.
Christmas.
And he's so wonderful. He's so wonderful.
Tony, we're going to bring you one of Jim Gilstrap's sweet potato pies. Yeah.
No, you're not. No, I'm not.
He said, I'm not.
Hey, Cy, safe travels
Thank
to
you.
Tokyo.
Yeah. Arigato gozaimasu.
All right.
Yeah, sukiyaki to you too.
Arigato.
And a very early, blessed, happy birthday.
Yes, enjoy.
It's your birthday back home in D.C., so happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you, Mama.
Did we get our go-go in tonight?
Yeah, we did get the go-go in, didn't we?
You did.
See you soon, listening audience, on
We Luvv Rare Grooves. Good night.
What happened, man? It's her birthday, man. Cy is so special. You know, it's her birthday.
Her birthday.
Cy Smith.